Hey guys, Daniel here with another tutorial for you, this time in Microsoft Outlook troubleshooting problems and how you can reset your profile to see if the problem is resolved that way. So very quickly before that, there are multiple steps you can do in troubleshooting your Outlook, and even before that, just to clarify, some people say my Outlook's not working, and they mean outlook.com, not Microsoft Outlook, the program, which is what we're talking about in this video. I don't know why Microsoft chose to give it the same name, but that's what they've done, and I get so many phone calls about this and so much confusion that I have to ask every time, what does it look like? What do you mean your Outlook doesn't work? Are you on a web browser or the program? They still don't even know. So it's kind of hard to troubleshoot that without looking at it and seeing which one they're talking about. So in this video, I'm talking about the program that you install on your computer, not a website. And if you're having a problem with your emails in that program, you can check your add-ons and disable all the add-ons in there, see if they're causing a problem. You can run it in safe mode by clicking the start button and just typing in outlook.exe/safe, and then it'll prompt you for your profile. Open it and see if the issue is resolved. If it works with the new or in safe mode, then it may be you need to create a new profile or one of the add-ons is a problem. So if you need to create a new profile, I'm going to show you how to do that. Stick around. Okay, so to start off with this, we go into Start menu and type in Control. You'll see the Control panel, and you can open it from there. And type in Mail to search for Mail, and we'll open up Microsoft Outlook. So from here, you can manage your email accounts and data files, but what we really want is to go into Show Profiles. And when we do that, we'll see the one profile that I've got. And actually, it would be set to always use this profile, so I had that on by mistake still from my previous failed video recording, so you didn't really see me just switch that. Okay, so when you go in here, you got your profile, and if there's only one, it is set to always use that profile, but what we want is to create another profile and prompt us when opening Outlook which profile we want to use. So we'll switch it to prompt, go to add, give it a name, whatever you want to call it, and hit OK. And then from here you have to create your email address, and you can run through the wizard here, set it up normally. All the settings are going to be from what you had in the previous profile, so I can't tell you what those settings are. It depends on your email address and all that stuff. Now if we cancel out of it, we got the message here that if you want to create a profile with no email accounts, you can hit OK. So that's cool, we want to do that. So we got the new profile, but the problem is that we still can't open Outlook using that profile without setting up an email account, or at least a data file in there. But this is the bottom line, at least. So if we hit OK and we go to launch Outlook, you'll see here it's prompting us for a profile to be used, so I can select the new profile. And when we open that, if you didn't already have your email account set up earlier in the control panel when setting up that new profile, then it will prompt you to set it up here. And I would suggest that depending on the problem you're having in Outlook, if you have multiple email accounts that you check in multiple data files, local PST files, just add the one main one where you're experiencing the problem in. Troubleshoot that one first, and then you'll see if that works in here in this new profile. Then you know the issue's resolved with a new profile, and then you can continue with adding your other email accounts and other data files. That's it. And resetting Outlook is really just going in here to create a new profile. So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and please comment. Let me know if you found it helpful, if you have any other questions, and what other kind of helpful videos do you want to see in the future. You can even make use of our community tab on the channel page, and you can answer some voting questions on what kind of videos you want to see, or just post some comments there and let me know what you're looking for. I'm here to help answer your questions and help you out with anything IT. So that's it for this video, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks. Bye for now.